Hey, how's it going? Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to A-B, kind of do a quick little compare and contrast of two of these popular multi-effects units, little personal portable multi-effects units that are on the market today. And by market, I basically mean Amazon. I have the Getaria Cube Baby, and there are several versions of this by other brands, I guess you would say. But the Getaria Cube Baby, pretty well regarded, pretty well rated on Amazon. $45, $44, around in that neighborhood for the Cube Baby. And the Mooer PE100, again, pretty well rated, pretty well reviewed, very popular on Amazon, about $88 for the Mooer. So, you know, what's the price difference? You know, which one of these might be right for you? I'm curious which one's going to be right for me, because what I'm doing is putting together a little portable electric guitar rig, a little travel rig that I can take with me anywhere. Nice, secure, watertight case. I'm going to go through that in another video. But in this video, we're just talking about the heart of that rig, which is really what I'm looking for right now, which is why I'm doing these videos. And sorry, upside down. So here they are, right beside each other, the Getaria Cube Baby and the Mooer PE100. Now, for comparison's sake, that right there is an iPhone 6. It's just a standard, regular old iPhone 6. So you can see these are both basically the size of a cell phone. The Mooer is a little thicker and a little wider. The Getaria is a little thinner and a little longer. Let me kind of let you kind of get a feel physically for the difference in these two units. Size-wise, okay? Now, let's talk about the differences functionally in these two units, because as you can see right off the bat, they're totally different approaches to basically the same category of unit, and that is one of these portable, personal, digital guitar effects units. So what do these things have in common? Where are they different? Obviously, they're very different physically. This one has buttons and knobs and stuff. This one's very smooth, kind of user interface, only a couple of knobs, no physical buttons anywhere. So that's a difference right off the bat. But to dig in a little bit further, I'm going to talk first about the Getaria. And I'm going to call this really a micro pedal board. And I think if you think of this in terms of a micro pedal board, you're probably going to be way ahead of the game in understanding the core differences between the Getaria and the Mooer. The Mooer, I'm going to call more of a true digital multi-effects unit. Yeah, they're both digital and they're both multi-effects units. So why am I calling this one more of a micro pedal board and this one more of a digital effects unit? Well, let's go through that. First of all, on the Getaria, you have actual foot switches, like heavy-duty foot switches. The entire chassis is metal. I mean, it's solid. It feels very solid. All the little knobs here have nice little rubber rings on them. Some of them have detents in the selections. Let's talk about the back panel. Again, why is this a micro pedal board, or why am I calling it that? Input and output, quarter-inch mono, mini stereo output for headphones, or really this just can think of this as a low-level stereo auxiliary out that can headphones obviously is going to be the primary use, but you can use it for other purposes. Power switch, which the Mooer doesn't have a power switch. Then a couple other ports here. This looks like a two mini or micro USBs right here. I guess mini USBs. This record port right here is not actually USB. It's just a USB connector on this end, and the other end has an actual little mini stereo jack that goes into the earphone port of your iPhone. So yeah, if you have an iPhone 6 like I do that actually has that little port in it right there, you could actually record directly to iPhone with this. They don't have one with a lot for a lightning adapter that I'm aware of just yet. The other port here is a true USB port. And from here, you can recharge the internal battery. It is internal battery powered with recharge, and it's rechargeable via the USB. You can also record directly to your DAW from this unit via USB using this actual pedal thing right here as your audio interface with the full effects in it. So that's really cool. You have basically a little mini audio interface directly into your DAW that you can record to. And finally, you can import impulse response files. And that is one of the big differentiators of this unit from the Mooer unit. The Getaria supports IR cab files and loading of additional or other IR cab files. The Mooer does not. So in that regard right there, this unit sounds much I guess you would say, more expensive, much bigger, much fancier than it is physically because of those IR files. I mean, when you get a, you know, 1024, 256 impulse, point impulse response files that you can load anything from the internet that's a standard IR cap file, you can load onto this unit right here. Totally changes the tone of this and really makes it sound like a high-end unit. It truly does, especially when you're comparing the two together. You run effects. It's not that the Mooer sounds bad. It doesn't sound bad at all. It sounds really good, but it doesn't sound as good as this when you activate these IR cabs. This really does sound good. So that's some of the reasons why I'm calling this more of a micro pedal board. All right, so let's talk about the Mooer unit again. What about this one? Why am I calling this more of a digital effects unit? Well, even on the back panel, you can see it's very basic. Input, output, auxiliary in, and headphone output. And that's it for the back panel. No, you can't use this as as an audio interface or anything like that. It does have, you can power it with DC power, but it's also battery powered with AAAs instead of an internal rechargeable like the Getaria. So I really like the AAAs of this unit. Now the Getaria is all metal chassis. The Mooer, not so much. Has a plastic back. It's solid feeling, but it's plastic back and metal trim, back panel here and front trim, and then just kind of a plexiglass sort of a face on it here because you actually can, this is touch sensitive, all of this stuff up here. Okay, so some more differences. Obviously, simple back panel. You can't use this as an interface, but here's some winning points for the Mooer. The Getaria, in terms of recall or storage ability of your, what you set up in here, you only get three options. That's it. You have three favorites, A, B, and C. That's it. That's all you can select. Or save, I should say, as your favorites. So that's another reason I call this more of a micro pedal board than a digital effects unit. It is a digital effects, but you can only save three effects and recall them as you saved them. Whereas on the Mooer, you have 99 factory effect chain combinations, 99 user programmable effects chains, and four instant select favorites available right here on the face of the unit. So much more programmability, storage, whatever you want to call it, for all of your effects and chains and things you want to set up in this unit. You also have actually more effects to choose from with the Mooer. You have wah, auto wah, and let's see. I think there's some... there's also some additional modulation effects and stuff in the Mooer. The Getaria, very basic. You have impulse response, reverb, mix for those. Your delays, so you have mix for your delay, feedback, and time. That's basically delay. And then modulation is just chorus. It's like there's a detent at the top, and like to the left is one, I don't know, flanger or something, and then to the right is like a different one, chorus or something like that. So you get a couple of options here, but not a whole lot of pedals, quote unquote, in this unit. And then you have your tone gain and amp type selection. So you can, there's no tube screamer pedal or anything like that modeled in this. Using tone and your gain and your amp models, yeah, you can get some distortion and overdrive and stuff like that going through here. And then when you add in those IR cab files, wow, I mean, it really opens up and it sounds amazing. But again, not that much to choose from in your little micro pedal board here, whereas the Mooer, many more digital effects are available to you. Now, one thing that I was really looking for my rig that I'm putting together is I want to be able to jam along with myself, like with my favorite songs or with jam tracks or something like that. I just want to practice if I'm, traveling or something like that. I just want to practice privately through headphones, just kind of jam to myself. Yes, both of these support that, but they do it in different ways. The Getaria does it via Bluetooth. Actual Bluetooth. You set this unit up very simply. It comes right up and it works. It did for me, at least, using this old iPhone 6. It did work. The second try, I had to turn it off and then back on, but it did work. No real problems. You set this up as a Bluetooth speaker in your phone, and then you play your music to that speaker. It actually blends in with your guitar signal right here, and you get a blended output signal, which is really pretty cool. So you can definitely play along with your favorite songs, jam tracks, stuff like that with the Getaria pedal, no problem. Can you do that with the Mooer? Yeah, absolutely you can, but you're going to need an auxiliary in cable. You're going to come out of your a phone or MP3 player into the aux in jack here, and then it's blended in, and of course it's blended in with your signal, and you hear it through the headphones. So two different approaches to the play along, jam along sort of a thing. But The Mooer adds one more little tweak to the equation that the Getaria does not, and that is right here with this little center button that says rhythm, right there, rhythm. This has 40 onboard rhythm patterns to select from, and that's plenty for jamming along. If you know, there's plenty of styles in there for you to just jam along with. It also has 10 metronomes, but I don't have a whole lot of use for the metronomes. I do like jamming. So this unit then becomes fully self-contained little jam along unit. It doesn't have a looper. I wish it did. Boy, that'd take it up to the next level. If they add a new version with a looper, I'm going to pick it up, because that's really going to make a nice little self-contained jam along rig. But as it is right now, I could play along with my favorite songs or jam tracks through the aux in, but I can also just use the unit by itself with these 40 rhythm tracks, patterns, whatever you want to call them, that are built into this. Terrific for jamming along by yourself. Do they sound great? Well, I mean, you probably wouldn't want to record with them, but just for jamming through your headphones and playing while you're on vacation or something, they sound absolutely great. So there you have it. I'm breaking them down like that. Micro pedal board. True digital multi-effects unit. Granted, as I said, they're both digital multi-effects unit. But this one, the construction, the whole execution of this seems to me to be much more like, as I said, a micro pedal board. So I'm keeping this one, and this one's going in my electric guitar case, right in the big pocket in my electric guitar case, because I would love to have a mod, a little effects pedal with me anywhere, anytime I'm going. Don't have to take my whole pedal board or anything like that. When I'm moving around with my own electric guitar, this is going in my electric guitar case, and that's going to be my micro pedal board that goes with that guitar everywhere. But for my actual travel rig that I'm putting together, I'm going with the Mooer unit. This one really just had all the other options. It was, it's twice as expensive, $88 for this versus about $43-44 for the Getaria. But having that onboard rhythm, having all the extra storage capabilities, having the extra effects that are available, digital effects here for you. And really, I didn't really, as I said, need an interface or any of the other fancy connections. These simple connections are all that I was interested in from the word go. So the Mooer unit definitely wins the day for me. And in the next video, I'm actually going to break down that whole travel rig right here. There's the case. I'm going to break down that whole travel rig, show you what I put in there, and hopefully you'll get some inspiration and some ideas, maybe put your own stuff together. So I hope this video has been helpful for you. Seeing a quick A-B comparison, let me just do one more little kind of roll it around, let you see the differences, kind of thicknesses, sizes, all that. That should give you a pretty good feel for both of these units. And I hope this video has helped you maybe make a decision on which one of these units is going to be right for you. We'll see you in the next video.